Okay, now coming to the seventh question, can two angles be supplementary if both of them are acute? This is the first part. Okay, now let us assume two acute angles, say 60 degree and say 40 degree. And if you find their sum, it comes 100 degree, which is less than 180 degree. So we say that two acute angles are not supplementary. Okay. Now the second part is, can two obtuse angles be supplementary? So let us take two obtuse angles and find say 100 degree and 110 degree and find their sum. It comes 210 degree, which is more than 180 degree. So again, two obtuse angles are not supplementary. Okay. Now come to the third part. We have to find can two angles be supplementary if both of them are right angles. So let us take two right angles, say 90 degree and 90 degree, find their sum, which is equal to 180 degree. So we say that two right angles are supplementary. All right, is this clear? Question number 8. An angle is greater than 45 degree. So see here, angle is greater than 45 degree. Matlab, it is not 45, it is more than 45. So let us assume the given angle equal to 45 plus x, kyunki it is more than 45, 45 se zyada hai. Now the next line is its complementary angle greater than 45, equal to 45 or less than 45? What this sentence means, when we find the complement of this angle, will it be greater than 45 degree or will it be equal to 45 degree or will it be less than 45 degree? So let us find the complement of this angle. So complement of 45 degree plus x is equal to what? 90 degree minus 45 degree plus x. So here little bit integers is involved, which we will be taking up in later on. When we open the bracket, it becomes 90 minus 45 degree minus x. Means actually what happens is minus plus is minus. You already did in class 6. Minus plus is minus. Got it? So 90 minus 45 degree is 45 degree and this minus comes. So what do you see here? The complement of this angle. See, complement of 45 plus x is what? 45 minus x. Matlab, it is less than 45 degree. So we will conclude that its complement will be less than 45 degree. Understood? Now question number 9. In the adjoining figure, this figure is given and these 4-5 parts are given. I have drawn these figures separately for each part. The same figure I have drawn repeatedly for each part. So let us start with the first part. The first part is angle 1 adjacent to angle 2? Sir, first let us locate where is angle 1. Angle 1 is here, AOC is angle 1 and COE is angle 2. Let us hide rest of the angles. See here. Okay. This point is O. Okay. Now is angle 1 adjacent to angle 2? So what do you see here? Angle 1 is adjacent to angle 2 because it OC is the common arm. OC is common arm. O is the common vertex. And non-common arms, they are OE and OA. OE and OA are non-common arms lying on either side of common arm. What is the common arm? Common arm is OC. So what do we say? We say angle 1 and angle 2 are adjacent. So angle 1 and angle 2 are adjacent. Alright. Now coming to the second part. Is AOC adjacent to AOE? AOC adjacent to AOE. Let us hide rest of the angles. Now here this is O. Let us see. AOC. AOC is which angle? This is AOC. And what is AOE? AOE is this angle. Understood? Now write here AOC and AOE. Okay. So now you see here what is the common arm? OA. OA. Common arm is OA. CA is equal to A means common arm is equal to common arm is OA. Now common vertex, see here in the figure the common vertex is O. Non-common arms. Now non-common arms, let us locate here. From here this is OC and from here it is OE. So non-common arms are OC and OE. Now you see here OC and OE, they are lying on the same side of the common arm OA. OA is here and OC and OE is also this side. So non-common arms OC and OE lie on same side of common arm OA. So what do we observe here? Here the two angles are not adjacent, that is angle AOC is not adjacent to angle AOE. Understood? Now let us come to the third part. Do COE, where is COE? COE is here. And EOD, where is EOD? EOD is here. Form a linear pair. So let us hide all the angles remaining. See here, this is COE and EOD. EOD is this one. Okay, now see here COD and COE and EOD. So we have to find out whether they form a linear pair. For linear pair, we need to find out that two angles should be adjacent and the sum should be 180 degree. Now see here this angle. And this is 3 plus 4. Okay. So, when we take angle 2 and angle 3 plus 4, we find that OE is the common arm. Because when you say C angle COE, OE comes, and when you say angle EOD, OE comes. So OE is the common arm, and O is the common vertex. O is the common vertex. Now the non-common arms, these are OC and OD. OC and OD are non-common arms lying on either side of common arm OE. OC and OD lie on either side of OE. OE is here and OC is this side and OD is this side. Okay. Then next, the sum of these two angles, angle 2 plus angle 3 plus 4, you see it is coming straight angle. So sum of angle COE, COE plus angle EOD, that is equal to angle 2 plus angle 3 plus angle 4, which is equal to 180 degree. So we say that the two angles are forming a linear pair. Now coming to the fourth part. Fourth part, what does it say? Are angles BOD. Where is angle BOD? BOD is this angle. And DOA? DOA is this angle. We have to find that these two angles are supplementary. Let us close all. Now you see here, angle BOD and DOA. Supplementary means some of these two angles, you see it is coming a straight angle. So angle 4 plus angle 5 is equal to 180 degree. So angle 4 is what? BOD. And 5 is what? Angle DOA are supplementary. Understood? Okay. Now the fifth part is angle 1 vertically opposite to angle 4? Let us see, where is angle 1? Angle 1 is here. This one is angle 1. Okay. And where is angle 4? This is angle 4. This is angle 4. Okay. So it is asked whether these two angles are vertically opposite or not. Let us hide the other angles. See here. These other angles I have put the paper, and now it is only visible this. So now you see here, when two lines intersect, pair of opposite angles are equal. Okay, so angle 1 and angle 4 are vertically opposite angles. So we write here, angle 1 is vertically opposite to angle 4, because when two lines intersect, pair of opposite angles are equal. And here DC and AB are the two lines intersecting at point O. So angle 1 is vertically opposite to angle 4. Alright. Now coming to the sixth part. What is the vertically opposite angle to angle 5? Now see here, this is angle 5. We have to find out the vertically opposite angle to this angle. So I will hide this angle here. And here I will hide this angle. Okay. Now you see here, when two lines intersect, pair of opposite angles are equal. So opposite to 5 is what? 2 plus 3. Is it clear? These are the two lines, AE and this one. These are the two lines. And angle 5 is here. So vertically opposite is 2 plus 3. So vertically opposite angle to angle 5 is angle 2 plus angle 3. Is it clear? So with this, I finish this question as well as today's session. In the next class, we shall start with the next question. Please do this question carefully. This is a very important question. So, wish you all the best. We'll meet in the next class.